stories about your fast train.
Hey there, train fans. Today we're standing outside our depot here at the Historic Rail Park and Train Museum in Bowling Green, Kentucky. This building, built in 1925, holds a lot of history inside its walls with our various exhibits. However, the building itself has a story of its own.
Bowling Green's downtown, as well as this building, would look a lot different if it wasn't for one item, limestone. Much of this area of Kentucky is part of a karst region, meaning there's a lot of limestone and other types of rock that have been eroded underground for many years and developed beautiful but sometimes dangerous natural phenomena like caves and sinkholes. Limestone is a highly sought-after material for construction due to its strength and durability, its wide availability in many parts of the world, and it's also flame-resistant. Some of the world's oldest buildings still standing today, such as the Great Pyramid of Giza, are made of limestone. In the case of Bowling Green, the sheer size of how much limestone is available adds to its value. With blocks being able to cut both horizontal and vertical, there's a versatile plethora of material ready to use. The first company to work the limestone in Bowling Green was the Whitestone Quarry, which was run and owned by John Hayworth in 1833. Before the railroad was made, mules would lug around the huge blocks to construction sites. But after the introduction of the LNN in 1850, the railroad became the preferred method of transportation until the company folded during the Great Depression.
As for our building itself, the limestone that you see provides aesthetic but also structural support.
The building is a prime example of Roman Revival architecture style, with a five-part facade that centers on a central block. The central block fixates on an Ionic order engaged portico that leads to the main waiting room and ticket booths. The building also reflects the time period it was built in, that being the middle of Jim Crow segregation. The limestone of Bowling Green has been used in other buildings all over the city and also in other places around the United States, such as Frankfort, Kentucky, and also Washington, D.C.
These white stones serve as not only historical artifacts, but also as an icon of Kentucky itself.
Hey everyone, I hope you enjoyed today's adventure. Did you know that you can help us here at the Historic Rail Park and Train Museum? If you're a kiddo watching, be sure to ask your parent to help you to go to www.historicrailpark.com, where you can learn more about trains and also about our 2020 campaign. With your generous help and support, we can continue to tell these exciting and amazing stories from beyond the rails. Uh-oh, the express is about to head out. I better get going. See you next time. Board! Oh, board!
About one all the southern folks have seen. She's the beauty of the Southland. Listen to